EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the World Steel Capital in the city of Bridges, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Acrisure Stadium. Today it's week three, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Dragons of Orlando taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. As of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Going to go to the air right away.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Well, this defense certainly knows they're going to have their hands full trying to slow down this passing game. Here's an example on the very first play from scrimmage. I think we'll see some different looks, maybe some pressure from different places, but it didn't work there, and it's a quick first down.
They run the option here on first and 10. That's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44.
A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Allen. Throw right side taken in by Pettis. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that's going to bring up second down.
The Steelers at 2-0 here to begin the season. They come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
On second down, here's the option. Shedding the tackle.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Here we go now on first and goal.
First and goal at the 1 yard line.
To throw, it's Allen. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Josh Allen, his 19th touchdown now on the season.
And the Steelers are on the board first here this afternoon.
Well, these guys scored touchdown after touchdown in that win a week ago. So how do they come out this week? Same way. They got that momentum going, a touchdown on the opening drive.
I think it's safe to say that they're in a groove, isn't it? I mean,
oh, this is blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. But he will not be able to bring this one back, and the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
Well, there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing it. We had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry about it. It's just 1 point. Oh, my. Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
I still can't believe they told the head coach to relax. Whoa.
Bad move. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. That's complete to Pierce. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Inside the 10. Touchdown. A great play there. His third rushing touchdown on the year. And the Dragons strike quickly here to tie up the ball game.
Now the try here for the extra point. It's up and good, so they go the conservative route instead, and it gets them a 7-6 lead here in the opening quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
Agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL, but it seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find the answers, and they've got to find them quick.
Allen's throw into the hands of Pickens.
Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it's second down.
So a decent gain there, but not their fourth consecutive first down like they had on the first three plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They've gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
From the 17, here's second and 4.
Now Allen.
Finding Pickens for another catch.
But he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum, because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
And in for the Steelers' touchdown from 4 yards out.
And the Steelers have retaken the lead.
Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good.
That'll make this a 6-point game. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And it looks like this one won't work out. Hands team able to secure the football.
Receiving team. From the gun, they'll try to run it.
There he goes, left side. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
88 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They gave him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guys at the cornerback position.
Now Mahomes throwing on second down. Dancing to his left.
And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
And here you're down in the red zone. You need to be smart, not force anything. So that's a wise decision to just get rid of the football.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Now here's Mahomes. Being chased out left. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through the completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing 4th down.
Now on 4th down, out comes the field goal unit here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And this one is right through. And that will cut the lead back down to 3 at 13-10.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
The partners are putting the defensive back. I'm not knowing much of physical reaction. Watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. And the defense closes quickly there. He'll get maybe a yard to the 33. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Now on 3rd and 2, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. He's got his running back out of the backfield. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big 3rd down pickup of 20 yards.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
They run the option here on 1st and 10. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line.
11 more yards that go around, a 1st down as well.
1st and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Allen going to keep it again.
And holding it, maybe the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Well, he's had success running the football in this one. Yeah, that's undeniable. But that time, the defense was on to it.
And, partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations and looks.
Allen looks to throw on 2nd down. Gets this one left side to Pettis. And 20 before he's brought down. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Partner, there's strong running plays, and then there are plays where you simply outclass the defense, and we saw the latter there. They ran straight up the heart of that front for an excellent gain and first down. Simply put, you've got to put up more of a fight defending the middle. Otherwise, this is going to be a long game.
With it on first down. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. From the gun, it's Allen. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Now Allen. And that nearly intercepted. Boy, for a guy known for his hands defensively, that's a ball he probably thinks he should have come up with. But instead, it's fourth down.
So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. From the left hash, a chip shot here.
McPherson's kick is good, and that extends their advantage to 6. It's 16-10. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the 3.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put 3 on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So the difference is 6 points as we get set to resume action here in this third quarter of play. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. On play action, it's Mahomes. And his throw here is incomplete.
And you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react control very quickly.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. That'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1 yard pickup leads to 4th down. Mahomes throwing on 4th. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in for the touchdown. A great effort there. 67 yards. And the Dragons' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Johnson now returning. Here comes Johnson on the return. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
A 3rd quarter now, to 1-point game as they line up 2nd and 10. Throwing now is Allen. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight end, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the 1st down.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. Now he's into the clear again. And all the way down to the 5. A big time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. 1st down.
Well, you know, most quarterbacks, when you talk about their big play ability, you talk about the arm, but this, an absolutely huge play with a leg.
And also with his mind, because he had to see this play develop in order to make the decision to keep it and run. And how about him looking up and seeing the C's part for him once he got past the line of scrimmage? My first thought, I think he can go all the way, and I'm trying not to take over your call of this play, partner. I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. On 2nd down, here's Allen. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Steelers have retaken a 3rd quarter lead.
So a very strong 1st drive in the 2nd half, Charles, as they turned that halftime deficit into a 3rd quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
Allen will try to throw for it. And he will find the end zone here, and the lead moves up to 7. So they're able to throw it in for the 2-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here, because if you do get it intercepted, it's returned by the defense. That's 2 points for them, but yeah, identify.
And the Hands team does its job. They're able to secure it. Mahomes now on first down. Throw to the right, hauled in by Addison. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
They go play fake. Mahomes.
Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Mahomes now to throw. There goes a deep ball in zone. And it's caught. Touchdown. Ja'Marr Chase, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Dragons are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. The try here for the extra point. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. We got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown, so every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. And meanwhile, Allen's throw complete to Freiermuth. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. The end result, 21 yards.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Allen now looks to throw. And here's Freiermuth again. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that. And that's what he did.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. And they'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And down inside the 40, about the 38. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Allen running the option to the left, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. He'll wind up getting 3 on the keeper there, but it leads to a third down.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And the question now, can they get closer on third down? A field goal from here, you're looking at right about a 52-yarder. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
Well, that's the fear any defense has when the quarterback gets involved in the running game. You don't usually account for him, and he's hurting them today.
Yeah, he's been very involved in the running game. Defensively, when you've got the coverage good downfield, how do you account for him, though?
Occasionally, you start to spy him. Take someone who has the same agility, who can dance with him, run with him, and try and keep him in the pocket.
Yeah, it'll be especially critical here as we come down the stretch in the fourth. Now this time, Allen will throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball got to the receiver, separates him from the catch, and normally he's a sure-handed target.
They'll try again here, second and 10. Remaining on EA Sports. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. Allen. On first down, they'll go to the ground to 10. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here's second down and 3. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Yeah.
Throwing, Allen.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
A big play here, third and two. Here's Allen. He's got his target. That's complete. And the Steelers are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And now whistles blow here. Play is stopped, and we're going to get a timeout as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
Now first and goal. Now Allen.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal.
And he's taken down. And now they can milk this, take it all the way down, call the timeout, and set up the game-winning field goal try.
Well, they would have loved to have scored a touchdown there, but this still sets them up for a game-winning field goal attempt.
And we are set for a great finish as that timeout comes in with 2 seconds to go in this football game. So all eyes now locked on Evan McPherson. 2 seconds on the clock, this for the win. And it is good! He splits the uprights on the chip shot, and the Steelers have won the game!
So no shortage of offense in this game, but a very clean game too, Charles. Each side got its points, but they did so without committing a single turnover.
That's so true, and it certainly felt like NFL football at its finest, right? You talk about the highest level for both of these offenses. Neither one of them afraid of taking risks, and both of them aggressively pushing it downfield. I did like, Brandon, how smart they were about going about their business, though. They were high-flying, but they took care of the ball.
Yeah, they did. And just keeping it clean in a game like this with all these points, you don't see that very often, even at the highest level. Job well done by both sides.
So for the Steelers, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Orlando, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.